Hi everyone, this is David and welcome to another of my IFR videos. In this video I will explain you or demonstrate you how the airspeed indicator works. And just for your info, this explanation is related to an article that I wrote about the airspeed indicator's operation. You'll find it on my webpage under the instruments section. Okay, so we are currently standing on a runway in a parked position, as you can see. For your information, also we have a zero wind condition. Okay, the reason I want to mention that is has something to do with our airspeed indicator and our pitot tube and static lines, but I will come to that later at the end of our lesson or of this explanation. So again, we are located on the runway in a parked position, and as you can see, the airspeed indicator is currently indicating 0 knots. And before we go deeper into that explanation, I will just show you the outside of the airplane very quickly. Just a moment, please. Okay, so here we have an outside look to our entire airplane, and here we have the left wing with the pitot tube attached to it. Of course, the left wing from the pilot's perspective. The static lines are usually attached to an area where we have no, where they are not affected by direct airflow or relative wind. So usually somewhere here, okay, more or less behind the engine cowling or to the lower side of the cockpit window, right here where my mouse is pointing, or they might be located at the very back of our tail. And again, the static port receives undisturbed air. Undisturbed air means, again, as I already mentioned, it's not affected by direct airflow or relative wind compared to the rest of the airframe, and especially the pitot tube. The pitot tube receives direct wind or direct airflow, also called relative wind. Okay, relative wind is always that opposite of your flight path. Okay, so if you're going this way, the relative wind would be coming from here, flying over the wing and around the airplane. Okay, and the operation or how the airspeed indicator works at the end, it's a pressure differential instrument, which means it basically measures the pressure difference between your wind that's going into your hole at the very front of your pitot tube, acting as pressure in your diaphragm of the airspeed indicator, okay? And the pitot the static ports, they basically receive undisturbed air, which is nothing else but the outside air pressure, which is outside of the airplane. Okay, if you step out of the airplane, that pressure that you feel around you is your outside air pressure, and that's what your static ports receive. And imagine again, if we are in a standing position, and especially if we have a zero wind condition, there is not much wind that's going into the pitot tube at this time. And the static ports will receive just as much pressure, so there will be an equalization, and your airspeed indicator indicates that as 0 knots. Okay, so again, back to the airplane. Okay, so here we are back in the cockpit again, and what I will do now is I will just go ahead and slowly put in some power, and what you will see is a slight increase in airspeed. Okay, our airspeed needle, our indicator's needle, will start a move to the right or clockwise. Okay, so I will unfreeze the sim. Okay, and I will slowly advance the power, about 1500 RPM or so. And what you will now see, is an increase in airspeed. Okay. So now, why is that happening? It's very simple. As we move, I will freeze the sim really quick. As we move, we now create an airflow automatically, or a relative wind around the airplane. Okay. And one more time, back to the outside of our airplane. Since we are moving now, this airflow is going directly into that pitot tube, while our static ports still receive the normal outside air pressure that I was talking about before. Okay, here we go. I will unfreeze the sim. And what you can see now, we are moving, and all this air that's coming from right in here is all going into the pitot tube, okay? So let me show you a picture again to give you a more in-depth explanation of what's going on inside the instrument. Okay, so here we have the airspeed indicator. Okay, here we have the pitot tube, and that's the instrument's case, and that's the diaphragm. Okay, so now what's happening at this moment? As when we were standing, we had, remember, we had outside air pressure from the static ports. Okay, that line goes into the entire instrument's case, and we had pressure going into the pitot tube. Okay, it's the wind basically acts as pressure and goes into the diaphragm. Okay. Since we had no difference in pressure there, nothing happened, okay? The airframe, diaphragm was stable, as well as the static pressure within the case. Now, when we advanced the throttle, the airplane started to move, okay? And when it did that, we created a relative wind because we're moving, okay? It's automatically a wind that's being created. And we also call that ram air, okay? And this ram air is going through the tiny hole in front of the pitot tube, going all the way through here and acting as a pressure in our diaphragm, okay? Now, since we're still on the ground, we did not take off yet, we still have the same outside air pressure within our instrument's case, okay? And now that difference in pressure will expand our diaphragm, okay? The diaphragm will become bigger, and as it's increasing, it will move these linkages and gears that you will see here, okay? And they are again connected to our little needle indicator of the airspeed indicator, and that will make it move clockwise, okay? When the diaphragm is expanding, it will move clockwise. When it's contracting, which means we have less pressure in here, it will go counterclockwise, okay, showing a decrease in speed. And that's basically what's going on within our instrument, okay? So let's go back to the airplane. Okay, so here we are back in our cockpit, and with the simulator is still on freeze, okay? So as we are moving and becoming faster, there's more relative wind passing or going into the pitot tube, creating more pressure on our diaphragm. That makes it expand, and that will show an increase in airspeed, okay? I will unfreeze the sim again to see how this will continue, okay? We can actually increase the throttle a little bit more, okay? Almost to full power, and you can see very close to liftoff speed right now, okay? Now let's say we would abort the takeoff, and aborting takeoff means we have power to idle, okay? And you will see that the needle will almost instantaneously stop moving and decrease. Okay, so I will unfreeze the sim, decrease the power to idle, and you will see that after just it's 2 or maybe 3 seconds, the airspeed indicator will show a decrease in speed. Now that's because since we're becoming slower again, the diaphragm will contract, okay, because now there is less airflow or less pressure acting on our diaphragm, okay. Pitot tube receives less pressure, less wind, or less relative wind, and that transfers directly as pressure, as a pressure decrease in our diaphragm, and that will make it contract, and the needle goes to the opposite side, showing us a decrease in airspeed, okay. And I will just hit the brakes. Here we go. Now, indicating 0 knots again, we are standing, and as you can see now, the diaphragm basically receives zero pressure, and the static ports are still measuring the outside air pressure, and they are equal, so to say, indicating 0 knots because there's no pressure difference anymore. Okay. Now back to my thing that I mentioned at the very beginning of this video. If we have a heavy headwind doing our taxiing by, for example, you might see some needle movement or needle fluctuations. That's because if the wind is blowing directly into the pitot tube, it's creating that pressure like instantly, and that will show like needle movements to the right, flipping back to the right, probably only by 10 knots or so, but that's basically the wind that's making the pressure difference within the instrument's case, and that's what we will see as needle movements. Okay, that's basically it. So I hope this lesson was helpful, and again, the article about this demonstration you will find on my webpage under the instrument section. But anyway, I hope this video was helpful, and have fun flying. Take care, see you soon, bye bye.